In this video, we'll take a look at a couple of examples of how to factor trinomials using what's called the Australian method. So first of all, let's start with this example. We're asked to factor 20x squared minus 7x minus 3. And so the first thing you have to do, and this is very similar to a method called decomposition, the first step's the same. You need to find a certain two numbers in order to do this factoring. The two numbers have to have a sum of negative 7, negative 7 being the coefficient of the linear term, often written in the middle, and have a product of the A number and the C number, which is 20 times negative 3, which is negative 60. So we need to look for two numbers that have a sum of negative 7 and a product of negative 60. And so there's lots of pairs of numbers that multiply at negative 60, but you're looking for the only one, only pair that has a sum of negative 7. And those numbers would be negative 12 and 5. So negative 12 and 5 do add to negative 7, and they do multiply to negative 60. Now, this first example I'm going to write in a little bit longer form just to explain than you would normally see it. So the first thing that you do is you take the a value, which is 20 in this case, and you write 20x times 20x over 20. So it's ax times ax over a, the a being the coefficient of the quadratic term. The next thing you do, and what you need these numbers for, is you rewrite this with the negative 12 after one of the 20x's and the plus 5 after the other. And it doesn't matter which order you write them. If you want to write the 20x plus 5 here and the 20x minus 12 here, that's fine. Now notice I'm not putting an equal sign between here and here because these two things are not equal. This is just how you factor using the Australian method. Everything else is going to be equal. Now notice that the next step, I mean, there's a common factor of 4 in this first binomial, and there's a common factor of 5 in this binomial. So we factor a 4 out of here. 4 goes into 25 times, that would be a 5x, and negative 12 divided by 4 is negative 3. And we factor a 5 out of this, 5 goes into 20x 4x times, and 5 goes into 5 once, it'd be 4x plus 1 in the end. Now, these two numbers here, their product is always going to be the same as the a here. So 4 times 5 is 20, so that 4 and 5 will divide out with the 20, and so what we're left with is 5x minus 3 times 4x plus 1. And so that is now factored. Now, just to show you how this would normally be written, most people wouldn't write these two steps out separately. So they would probably start by writing just the 20x and 20x and leave a little, I mean, if you hadn't found the numbers yet, you might write 20x, leave a little space, write 20x, another factor, leave a little space over 20. And so once you've got the negative 12 and the 5, you would, of course, put them in there. And then, of course, factor the 4 out and the 5 out and divide them out, and you get 5x minus 3 times 4x plus 1. So it would look something like that, what you would normally write. Now let's take a look at one more example. Let's say you're asked to factor 6x squared plus x minus 35. So we'd be looking for two numbers that have a sum of 1, because the coefficient of the linear term is 1. There's a 1x here. And a product of 6 times negative 35 is negative 210. Now I'm going to show you how to factor this using the Australian method. The other thing I want to mention here is that notice this is a case where the product is fairly large, but the sum is really small. The sum is really close to 0. In fact, there's only 1 from 0. And if that's the case, if the product is large, actually, I guess the product wouldn't have to be large. The fact that the sum is really close to 0 means that the two numbers you're looking for are very close to the square root of this number. Not the negative 210, just 210. So if you take the square root of 210, it's about 14.5. And so a good guess for the numbers that would add to 1 and multiply to negative 210 is use the numbers 1 above and 1 below, and depends if the sum is a little bit bigger, maybe, you know, 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or something like that, a little bit further from 0, you might have to use, instead of 15 and 14, you might go to, you know, 16 and 13 or something like that. So 15 and 14 are a little bit bigger and a little bit smaller than 14. Now, it's supposed to have a sum of 1 and a negative product. So 1 has to be negative and 1 has to be positive. So that's why the 15 would have to be positive and the 14 negative, because it has to add to positive 1. And that's the verification here. And they do multiply to negative 210. So those are the numbers we want that have a sum of 1 and a product of negative 210. So that's our numbers. So we write down, in this case, the a value is 6. We go 6x times 6x over 6. And then we want to stick the 15 and the negative 14 in here. So there's 15 and negative 14. And we can common factor a 3 out of here and a 2 out of here. And so it would look like that. The 3 comes out of here. 6x divided by 3 is 2x. 15 divided by 3 is 5. 2 it goes into 6x 3x times. And negative 14 divided by 2 is negative 7. And of course, 3 times 2 is 6. So they divide it with the 6 down here. And your factors are 2x plus 5 times 3x minus 7. So that's a couple of examples of how you factor using the Australian method.